Okay, thank you, Ron. So I'm going to talk about the study for the development of a European standard for displacement damage testing. This study is supported by ESA, who wish to fill a gap in this topic, as presented by Christian Poivet yesterday. If you don't know about ONERA activity, I can come and see me. I will give you some documents about our irradiation and testing activity on devices and materials. So what is the context first? As you all know, some guidelines exist for the radiation test activity, and especially for total dose and single events. Also, as presented by the previous presenter, some document exists for displacement damages. I gave some example, the same as previously, given by the NASA for proton testing or for a recent displacement damage guideline given by ESA about imaging devices. But there is no equivalence for total dose and single events for a general document for the displacement damage activity. So there is a strong need in displacement damage guidelines. We can ask, why is there a lack in standardization for displacement damages? Maybe first because it concerns only some types of devices, mainly optoelectronic devices that emits or detects radiation, optical radiations, but also some more classical devices like bipolar transistors. Anyway, it's a limited list of device types. A second reason is that there is a wide range of material depending on the wavelengths of interest for light detection or emission. You will need different material with different gaps. And this leads to a wider domain of study. And it is more complex to interpret the results. Also, even if there is available literature on the displacement damage, it is not as large as TID and ECE, because maybe lesser technological interest, difficulty in testing by association of both optical and electrical stimulation or measurements, and in some cases, high cost of devices. So the goal of the study is clearly to propose a displacement damage test standard that should be available by the end of the year. A draft version should be presented to the Component Technology Board Radiation Working Group before a final acceptance. And the goal of this presentation is not to propose a draft of the future guideline, because it's much too early to propose such a thing. But I will remind the physical processes responsible of the displacement damages, remind the electrical effects, main electrical effects, and try to present a list of the main parameters that should be taken into account for displacement damage guideline. So after this long introduction, you have the two parts of the presentation, the displacement damage causes and the effects, and a list of the key parameters as I tried to sort from pre to post irradiation. So concerning the transfer of energy from the particle to the matter, as you all know, the particle transfer energy mainly by interaction between the electrons and the particle. It is the transient effects and the ionizing dose depending on the concentration of the electron hole pairs created and where it happens, in the oxide or in the bulk. And a part of the energy is deposited thanks to atomic displacement. This is an interaction between the nuclei and the particle. A fraction of the energy depends on the particle and the matter, the energy of the particle, of course. And this fraction generally decreases when the energy increases. And you should remind that the displacement damage is a bulk effect in the device. Here you have a presentation of the different interactions in the matter for displacement damages. Mainly three interactions, Coulombian interaction corresponding to electrostatic attraction or repulsion of the particle and the nuclei. Also, a shock between a real shock between the particle and the nucleus, nuclear elastic, or nuclear inelastic, corresponding to first an absorption of the particle by the nucleus, then a spallation reaction dealing with fragments, and the nucleus explodes. Depending on the transferred energy, that can vary from interaction to interaction, and from interaction type to interaction type, you may have only simple events, which is called Frenkel pair. You create a pair of vacancy and interstitial here, or a cascade of interactions that can make a lot of Frenkel pairs. And after irradiation, you have the interstitial and the vacancies are very mobile in the lattice. So you have a reorganization of these pairs in two stable defects. This is what we call an annealing phase that may be very rapid. This depends on the temperatures, depends on the current injection and things like that. And this introduces some levels in the band gaps, defects levels, that modify the electrical properties of the semiconductor. Here you have a presentation of a trap, which is defined by its level in the band gap from the balance band or to the conduction band, and to its availability to capture or to emit some holes or electrons. So the electrical effects depends on the defects density deposited in the lattice, and their corresponding parameters as presented previously, and also to the carrier concentration, mainly the minority carrier's concentration. As you can see here, there are different interactions that can occur. If the carrier concentration is very low, you can have generation phenomenon. This is a question on electron hole pairs. If the density is quite high, you have a recombination of the electron hole pairs. This corresponds to different effects, electrical effects. This is mainly for defects that are close to the mid gap. For defects that are close to the bands, you can have trapping effects from electron off or holes. Also, from majority carriers, you can have a modification of the effective concentration of doping concentration, and some particular effects in a region with high electric fields. So the effects on devices are presented in the previous presentation. You have for solar cells, output power, short circuit current, output voltage. For photodetectors, the leakage current, also called dark current. The dark current uniformity for arrays, charge transfer efficiency corresponding to traps, trapping of charges and release. RTS phenomena, much complex. Bipolar transistor, this is a change in the bus current and generally a decrease in the gain. For optocouplers, you have both the degradation of the LED and the transistor, dealing with the CTR degradation, as presented earlier. For LEDs, for example, it's a light power output decrease, and for laser diodes, for example, the threshold current increase. So I'm going to introduce the non-ionizing energy loss, the NIL, which is a rate at which the energy is lost to displacement. This is analogous to the LET linear energy transfer for ionizing effects, with the same unity, and remind that the NIL is a mean parameter. This is the way we can calculate the NIL along all the energies that can be transferred by an interaction to the matter from a threshold level to a maximum level. You have to take into account the cross-section, differential cross-section, the energy transferred, and the fraction of the energy, which in turn will generate displacement damages. Reminds that in the transferred energy, you have a large part, which is ionization. And here you have some example of the NILs for protons, neutrons, and electrons in silicon, assuming a given threshold energy. You can calculate as for the ionization, the total ionizing dose, you can calculate the displacement damage dose. For energetic and mono-energetic irradiation, it is a